In Hinduism, each of the divine gods and goddesses have their own animal escorts. These are also called as vahanas or animal vehicles. The literal meaning of a vahana is something which carries or pulls. While different gods are associated with different vahanas or animal escorts. Lord Indra, the god of gods, is associated with a white elephant called Airavat. Airavat is also called as Ardhamatanga, meaning elephant of the clouds. Nagamalla, meaning the fighting elephant. And Arkasodhara, meaning brother of the sun. Airavat is the mythological winged white elephant who is said to carry God Indra, the god of gods.
Once, Lord Indra thought of his need for an elephant at his bay. He decided to have an elephant because he needed to be carried to many events in the Devlok, heaven, or elsewhere, along with the various battles taking place in his life. Hence, it is believed that Lord Indra went to Lord Brahma with his request for an escort of his own. So, Lord Brahma, who is considered to be the god of creation, decided to grant Lord Indra's wish for his very own escort. When Lord Indra went to Brahmalok, where Lord Brahma resided, and he then approached Brahma with his request. Hearing to his request, Lord Brahma dismissed Lord Indra and told him to come back the very next day and he would have his very own elephant. Soon, after Lord Indra was dismissed from Lord Brahma's presence, the bird Garuda was called upon by Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma called upon the divine bird in order to have him produce a sacred egg. According to him, this sacred egg produced by the bird Garuda, which would bring life to an elephant. This elephant would then serve as a faithful and loyal escort to Lord Indra. As soon as the bird Garuda received the request from Lord Brahma himself, he immediately flew over the place where Lord Brahma lived. He then hatched an egg and dropped it there at Brahmalok. That would soon give birth to Airavat, an elephant. The egg is said to have made such a loud noise that it had awakened Lord Brahma to begin his rituals to produce the divine Airavat. Brahma took his egg, delivered by Garuda, into his celestial room, and there he began to chant and sing religious mantras. As Brahma continued to chant further, the egg started to crack into tiny pieces. It cracked so until it eventually broke open. As soon as the egg burst open, a large elephant with four tusks and seven trunks popped out of it. Just after the moment the elephant came out of its egg, Lord Brahma called it as Airavat. This elephant was therefore named Airavat. Upon witnessing this elephant breaking out of the egg, Lord Brahma was extremely pleased. He saw that this elephant that was produced from the egg that Garuda had delivered was perfectly fit to become the royal escort of Lord Indra. He then went on to bless Lord Indra with an animal escort like he had always wanted and gave him the ownership of Airavat. So he informed Lord Indra to come and inspect this new and magnificent creation. After learning about the message from Lord Brahma, Lord Indra arrived soon and was extremely pleased with the large, beautiful white elephant, Airavat, that was in front of him. Lord Indra then thanked Lord Brahma profusely for granting his wish. Soon after that, Lord Indra took Airavat to his home, where Airavat is said to have lived with him eternally. Thank you.